Hi, can I help you?
I think it was a Sunday, sometime in January. I could be wrong, and I guess it isn't necessary. But I remember that the ground was made of snow. And if you went outside, you better take your coat. I must have been 19 years old. I had a cashier job at a convenience store, working the counter, making minimum dough, selling discount smokes to the neighborhood folks. I didn't pay much thought to his ski mask. It's Minnesota, man, your face will freeze fast. But I bet that I looked sorta dumb when I first caught sight of his bright orange gun. There I am, adrenaline high, and trying to decide how I feel about his right hand. Is that a goddamn? Wait a minute, it is a flare gun, and guess where he's aiming it? You probably ain't here to win the lottery, so you obviously gotta be robbing me. He nodded his head, so I opened up the till and grabbed a paper bag for the money, cause I know the drill. I handed in the cash and the food stamps. He just stood there looking all confused, and I'm thinking, yo, why the fuck ain't he moving? Come on, crazy white boy, don't do something stupid. That bag is worth maybe $230. Not enough for you to pull the trigger back and burn me. By now, you should be down the street. Ain't you ever seen the way they do this shit on TV? Yeah, it was fun, but it's done. Now get out.
Do you want me to lay down on the ground and start counting?
Before the ski mask even started nodding, I was already on that.
1-1000, 2-1000.
The front door beeped, I heard him leave, so I called my boss and the Richfield police. Gotta close the shop and lock the doors, cause some trailer trash just robbed the store.
I don't know, maybe 5'10"?
What was he wearing?
Skinny flannel shirt, ski mask, yeah.
How much money?
$230, maybe $250.
With a flare gun?
Yeah, it was a flare gun.
Like a
fucking flare gun, yeah.
A flare gun,
a ball of fire. Yo, a ball of fire comes out of it. Why you laughing? I point a flare gun at you, man.
Everybody acted so suspicious. I guess the flare gun story seemed fictitious. Are you accusing me of petty embezzlement? Don't you see my leftover adrenaline? Bosses and cops can't be my friend. Never felt loyalty to either again. And to keep it real, the irony didn't set until a year later when I got fired for stealing cigarettes.